Hi everyone, Tom here, and sometimes normal just does not cut it anymore. You need something bigger, something better. Like for my pet project, the Cerberus Reborn printer, which has a pretty massive hexagon-shaped print bed with an outer diameter of 350 millimeters. And since I hate waiting, I decided that it needed an equally massive heater. So in my case, I ordered a 650 watt silicone heater, but now that I think about it, I should have gone with the full kilowatt. Still, it heats up the bed to 120 degrees within about 5 minutes, which is okay. Now, with insane loads like these, it is going to be practically impossible to run them off of a 12 or 24 volt power supply. Not only is the power supply going to be ridiculously large and expensive, but you'll also have to deal with the kinds of current a bed with this kind of power would draw. About 55 amps on 12 volts, so you'd have to use supermassive wiring as well, which is a real pain to do right. So to deal with this, we're going to need AC straight from the plug. Of course, using a heater made specifically for your mains voltage of choice, don't connect the regular 12 volt heater to the mains. And another word of warning here, mains voltage is always painful and sometimes deadly, so please be very, very careful when you start working with 120 or 230 volts AC. Make sure you take care of every possible way you could touch high voltage, and don't be ashamed to get assistance from someone who at the very least knows how to properly use protected earth. So what a solid state relay can do, just like a regular relay, is to take a low voltage and low power control signal and use that to switch a high power or high voltage load. The input is 100% insulated from the output, so you don't have to worry about the mains voltage frying your electronics. Hooking up a solid state relay is pretty easy actually. Connect the output side in series with your load. So connect one lead of the load or heated bed or whatever you want to drive directly to one side of your power source, your main input, preferably the neutral phase, and connect the other lead to one of the output terminals of the relay. Which terminal on the SSR you use doesn't matter since you're dealing with AC voltage here. As long as you connect it to the output side of the SSR, that is. Connect the other terminal of the SSR to the remaining side of your input power. This is preferably live phase this time, and you're good to go. Then to actually switch things, connect the input side of the SSR to the power output of your control board. This time around, polarity does matter, so connect the positive side of the output to the positive side of your SSR input. If you're in doubt which side of your control board output is positive or negative, check out whatever documentation about your board is available online, or use a multimeter to measure the output voltage when that output is turned on. Then, if you just hooked up a heater, connect that heater's thermistor just like you would with a regular low voltage heater element, and you should be good to go. These SSRs don't require much or any cooling if you're using them for what they're intended for. And you might ask, well, what exactly are they intended for then? So the most crucial thing about most of them is, through the way these work internally, they can only switch AC voltages properly. If you try to use them for 12 or 24 volt DC, like what your typical power brick outputs, you are running them outside of their specifications. And what will happen is that either the SSR gets hot, melts down, always leaves your load powered up, or summons magical unicorns or other stuff like that. There are special solid state relays that are specifically made to also switch DC, but they can be hard to find and are more expensive than regular AC only relays. So really, if all you want to do is to control DC, you're probably better off just using a properly sized MOSFET. Once I get around to making a video about using them properly, I'll have it linked right here, there, I don't know. The other thing you should know about solid state relays is that they can't actually turn off all the way. So when their output should be off, they'll always have a slight leakage current of a few milliamps, which isn't a huge deal with heaters, but it might cause some trouble if you're trying to switch electronic loads with them. There is always going to be a small current that might make, say, a power supply behave erratically. And lastly, if your firmware lets you configure the PWM frequency of the output you're using to control the SSR, use the lowest frequency possible. With an SSR, this will actually make the heating cycle more accurate, even if it says something else in the comments to that setting. If you keep these things in mind, even the very cheapest $5 Fotech SSRs will run cool and reliably even when you're switching insane heaters like this one. If you now feel like buying an SSR and want to support my channel at the same time, feel free to use the eBay links in the video description. Those give me a small kickback when you buy 3D printer parts or anything else through them. Rate this video with a thumbs up or down, depending on whether or not you want me to keep making videos like this one. Subscribe if you're already totally convinced that you want to see everything I upload. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.